so excited because today I've got some really exciting mail from STELR, and there's a bit of a spoiler as to what's in this box, but this box we're going to unbox. My name is Lee, and today together we're going to go through the ins, outs, and engineering behind making my own wind turbine. You might have seen something that looks like this. That is a wind turbine. When the air moves through these parts, which are the blades, it causes them to turn, and it's this motion that powers a generator inside. The generator turns this moving energy into electricity that we can use to power anything from the lights in a stadium to the device you're using to watch this video right now. All right, so now we've got the basics, let's take a look at all of our equipment. Here are all the things I've unboxed from the STELR wind turbine kit. A mini test rig module, an anemometer, cables, some more cables, clamping hubs, a base plate, a multimeter, a battery, a rod, a boss head, turbine blades in small, medium, and large, and of course, a wind turbine generator. There are a few steps to making this wind turbine hum. First of all, I've got to take the nut off the end of that rod so that I can secure it to the base plate. Next, I'm taking the boss head and I am clamping that on at the point where I want my wind turbine to be. Next up, I'm taking that wind turbine generator, and in the back, I'm slotting two of the cables, one red and one black. Now I'm going to use the other side of my boss head to screw the wind turbine generator in place. Now I need to attach the other end of the cables to my test rig. I'm putting the red or positive cable in a lamp of my choice, and then putting the black or negative cable into the point that says COM. With the other cables from the kit, I'm attaching them to their corresponding red and black cables on the test rig, and the other end of those cables go into my multimeter. The black cable goes into the COM spot, and the red one goes on the right side. Make sure that you adjust your multimeter so that you're able to test DC voltage. The clamping hubs contain holes around the edge, which is where my blades can go. I can loosen them by turning the blue knob and then slot my blades in where I want them to go before tightening it again. When my blades are attached, I can put the clamping hub into the wind turbine generator using that lower socket. When the blades turn, this makes a coil of wire spin inside the generator, sending electrons down the cables and through the circuit so that my lamp will light up and I should be able to read a voltage on my multimeter. Okay, now we've got our wind turbine set up, we need a wind source. Place the 3-speed fan on the bench so that the front of the fan is 50 centimeters from the front of the hub of the wind turbine. And do not change the distance between the fan and the turbine over the course of the experiment. So there are three big questions we're going to be answering together today. What is the best angle for the blades to be at? How long should the blades be? And how many blades should we have? Test one, blade angle. In this activity, we'll be finding out what the difference in angle of the blades makes to the power output of our STELR wind turbine. First, we'll start with 45 degrees and two blades. Make sure the blades are tight on the hub of the turbine and are both at 45 degree angles to the face of the hub. Set the multimeter to the B scale. Turn the fan on to the highest setting. Once a steady reading is obtained, record the current and the voltage. Now test other angles, 15, 30, 60, and 90 degrees.
We can harness wind energy more efficiently by working out which angle to have the blades at on the turbine. How did we come up with this? Well, the answer is biomimicry. Biomimicry is when scientists and engineers take amazing stuff from nature and turn it into technology. For example, the humpback whale has these small bumps along its flippers which allow it to glide through the ocean without any resistance. This form of aerodynamics has been copied in a lot of different wind turbine designs from around the world. How deadly is that?
So, how'd you go? These are my results. As you can see, 15 degrees worked best for me, and I think that might be because it was a shallower angle, so it had more surface area open to the oncoming wind.